Man, who told you that musical chairs are only for children? That is a fun game, and you can just ask these 40 and 50 year old men because they are the GOAT at musical chairs. I'm like, I know you probably like, damn, what are you talking about? Man, another one of these coaches are swapping and flopping and flopping and hopping, man. I mean, it's getting so out of hand that I can't even keep up with it, man. Mario Cristobal from Oregon. Yes, Oregon University has left and came right to the 305, came right to Dade County, Florida, man, to coach the Miami Hurricanes, man. This one is not really a big surprise to me as the other ones because, man, this is a Dade County 305 dude, man. This dude is from Miami, man. He coached FIU. He played for Miami. He was born in Miami, grew up in Miami, man. He even was an assistant coach at one point in Miami at the University of Miami. So this one really ain't kind of, you know, surprise anybody, man. At least it didn't surprise me, man. This dude wanted to come home. He wanted to come to the crib to where it's at, man. I actually love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. You know, I love when these dudes, man, who understand the state of Florida, who grew up in the state of Florida, want to come back home, man. I'm a Florida dude myself, so I can absolutely relate to that, man. And this guy, he spent some time at Florida International University, FIU. Then he went to Oregon, you know, had some success in Oregon, had a 12-win season in 2019 and having a 10-win season this year. But he said, man, I love this Nike shit. I love, you know, Eugene. I love all of that. But I got to go home, man. And my dude went home. I can't fault him for it. Out of all of the coaches, you know, playing this game of musical chairs, this one really seemed like the most predictable one. I know they had some people linking Lane Kiffin to Miami. I don't know, man. People avoiding Lane Kiffin like the plague. I think Lane Kiffin might just end up staying at Ole Miss. I think he learned from his mistakes from his share of this musical chairs game, and that didn't play out too well for him. So I don't think Lane Kiffin gonna go anywhere. But it definitely ain't Miami because the 305 kid himself is coming back home. Welcome home, baby boy. What's up, man? Welcome home. Welcome home. I'm not a Miami fan. I'm a Gators fan, but I still love it from Miami, man. You know, I know that they had a couple of dudes, you know, trying to fix the program. You know, this is not the first time that they had a guy who was from the area who played at the school. I know Mark Rich wasn't from Miami, but he played at Miami. But this dude is born and raised, man. So this is different, man. His mom, his dad, his, you know, sisters, aunties, whatever, man. They can come there. They can be at the game, man. They be there, man. Family reunions. He don't have to go hop on no plane for no Thanksgiving. Or no, I don't have to worry about missing no holidays, man. He gonna be with his family. This is a straight personal move, man. Yes, I know Oregon is a better program and it's in like at a better state right now, but man, this is a dude who want to come home, man. And just like some of these players get homesick, a lot of these coaches get homesick, man. Especially some of these coaches, man, they end up in areas that they would have never went to, man, if it wasn't for their job, man. This is a guy who spent some time in New Jersey at Rutgers and been in Alabama. Now he's in Oregon. He's like, man, I want to come home. I miss the sunshine. I miss the water. I miss all of that shit. Welcome back home, man. I love it. I love this pick. I love it. I don't know if he's going to have much success at Miami. Miami is a program that it's like a success in the football team is more than just the coaches, man. I think that that's a rotten root that stems even down to the administrators of the school. Miami has always been a program that's been having internal battles. You know, they used to have this issue where they had this great success playing football, but the old president back in the day wanted it to be the Harvard of the South. They got rid of the Orange Bowl stadium. Now they have to play this off-campus stadium, so attendance is a major issue for them. They really only have, you know, sellout games whenever, you know, Florida State come to town or depend on certain matchups. But, you know, a lot of people don't want to drive half an hour or however long it is, man, from Coral Gables to, you know, to the Miami Gardens where the stadium is at, man. So, this Miami's not an easy job. I will say that you can have great coaches at Miami and not succeed at Miami, because this is a school that has some rotten cores, man, some rotten roots. I'm not trying to talk down on Miami, not trying to insult them. Last time I checked, Miami don't even have an athletic director. I'll have to look in on that. This is a great fit, but I'm not sure how much success he will have, because Miami is such a hard job, man, because you're not just competing on the field, but you have to compete with unnecessary external factors behind closed doors off the field. So I hope this guy can have success. I would love to see Miami competitive again, man. I am a Florida boy through and through, so I love to see maximum competition between the in-state schools, even them doggone Florida State, man. I don't like any of these Florida teams to be down. I love when it's primetime matchups. You know, I don't like when both teams are, like this year, the Gators, when we played Florida State, we were fighting for eligibility, and I've been calling that the damn pillow bowl, because that's like a goddamn pillow fight, because both teams are just pathetic from where they should be. So, you know, I'm tired of these damn pillow fights between these historic Florida programs in a state that is so talented. They have so much NFL talent, and especially in Miami, there is no reason why Miami should not be competing for national championships yearly, given the talent that's there, man. I mean, Miami has more players coming out of the NFL, more players being sent to the NFL, I should say, than any city in America. And you can fact check that. Miami is a fucking hotbed for football. And not just Miami, but those neighboring areas. Like, don't sleep on Broward County, shoot. If anybody is familiar with Florida high school football, Broward County and Miami football is the truth. So, man, you know, if this guy can get the local in-state recruits, or local, not just in-state, but city recruits, the local recruits to stay in Miami, that would be huge, man. Because I remember, look at James Cook, Dalvin Cook, little brother. He's in Georgia. Dalvin Cook left Miami and went all the way to Tallahassee. Guys like Lamar Jackson, you know, he's from Pompano and Broward. You know, that's like, what, 30 minutes away, you know, I'm from Miami. Calvin Ridley is another Broward kid, you know, went to Alabama. Jerry Jeudy, another Broward kid, went to Alabama. You got a lot of these. Amari Cooper, man, he played at Northwestern High School in Miami, went to Alabama. You got a lot of guys leaving South Florida to go play, not just out away from South Florida, but out of the damn state of Florida in general, man. And I hate that shit. You know, I would love for Miami and Florida and Florida State to capitalize on all of the local recruits, but Miami especially, because these are guys in your own backyard, man. Like, these are guys that all you got to do is turn the corner and you are at their high school, you are at their house, man. So there's a lot of talent down there. This is a guy who understands that, too, because he's born and raised in Miami. His family's from Miami. He has roots in Miami. His network is in Miami, you know. So this is a guy who fully understands that. So will he be able to recruit in Miami? I don't know, man. You know, I don't know, but I know one of the problems is, you know, I know some some guys personally who they took visits to Miami, and I asked them, man, you know, how was the visit? And they were saying that, man, it was cool or whatever, but man, compared to the other schools, man, the athletic facilities are kind of like, you know, man, it's kind of like one of the cats told me, man, Miami is like a really big high school, you know, more so than it is a small college, you know. And we know that these private schools tend to have, you know, they're not as big as these public colleges. But a dude told me, man, you know, like there's certain schools out, and these are Florida kids telling me this, but you know, they're like, man, there's certain schools, high schools in the state of Texas that they wouldn't be surprised if they have better facilities than Miami, or equal facilities, I should say, as Miami. And you know, that's something that Miami definitely has to improve on. I think the number one thing too, Miami has to find a way to have an on-campus stadium. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. You see, USF is talking about bringing an on-campus stadium because they see how far that put them behind them from their rival UCF. UCF accepted a bid to the Big 12, and they've been having a lot of success, and that's because they had a school that supported and donated and invested in their football program, and that paid off for all of their sports, man. And one thing about football is like just a leaking giant. You focus on football and that revenue will bleed into all of your sports, even the academics. That's why football is so important, man. It brings so much money, and USF is starting to realize that, and they're trying to invest in getting an on-campus stadium, and I feel like Miami should too. You know, they need an on-campus stadium, because one thing about it, man, a lot of times people, they don't want to drive, you know, through traffic and go through all of this shit just to go to a home game, man. They want to be able to walk to it, you know, walk from, you know what I mean? They want to be close by. They wanted to be close by the campus. They want to be close by everything, man, you know, so people can, you know. So I don't know, man. You know how it is, man. But they just gotta get an on-campus stadium. That's number one, and they gotta get their own home bed, man. Because that's not really their stadium. That's the Dolphin Stadium that they play in, and that sets them right, man. So I don't know what Miami's plan on that, but they need administrators to invest in that football program, and that will help the entire school out tremendously, man. So Mario Cristobal, man, I'm glad that you are able to go back home. I wish you the best success. I know there's going to be some obstacles. I know there's going to be some growing pains, but another good thing though, with Miami, with the state of Miami right now, you know, if you can win 10 games with Miami, they're going to be celebrating and hurrahing, because this is a team that fell far from glory, and they're just desperate to be relevant. They're desperate to be competing for the conference, the ACC. They're desperate to start, you know, they play Florida State, you know, competitively, but you know, they're just desperate to be back on top. Everybody talk about Texas is Texas bright, because Texas bright, man. Miami is like every 5 years people say is Miami bright, you know. So I don't think that this is going to be something where you're going to see major results in year one. I think it's going to take them a while. Miami, you're just going to have to realize where you are right now, and realize that this is going to take some time. If you are expecting a guy to produce in just 2 or 3 years and bring y'all to national, you know, championship contention, you are out of your fucking mind. That's not going to happen. I'm not taking nothing from Mario Cristobal. I'm just saying with all of the given factors that are going on with Miami internally and externally, man, this is something that where Miami's just going to have to restructure itself from the inside out, man, and just have a guy there that they're going to have to be patient with while they cleanse up, you know. So I love the hire. I love the hometown kid returning home. I hope it's not like a Scott Frost kind of thing where, you know, he go to Nebraska and he struggles. Obviously, the circumstances are different because Scott Frost was never coaching at a Power 5 team. Mario Cristobal is coming from, you know, Oregon, you know. So, So yeah, man, you know, I think that, you know, that those situations are very different. Oregon, I don't know, man, like, to be honest, as a coach, I think Mario Cristobal is solid. I honestly would not put him in a, definitely would not put him in a tier one, category of coaches. I would say if I would have to give him a letter grade, I would kind of give him like that B plus kind of area, just to think, you know, just because, I don't know, man. I watched this dude at FIU, and I watched this guy coach at FIU, and not trying to insult him or anything, but I don't know how the hell he got that job from Oregon to FIU, because his best season at Florida International was an 8-5 season in 2011, and that was the only time he has won 8 games. And his second best season was the year before that, was 7-6 in 2010, and then the rest of that was just 5-win, 3-win, even a 1-win season his first year there. So I don't know how the hell he got the job at Oregon. He must know how to present himself very well. Like I said, I'm not trying to talk down on the dude. And then especially FIU is another program that has a lot of internal rotten roots. So I that's definitely a program that's really hard, like really hard to succeed at. So I don't really hold that against them. But yeah, man, we just have to see. We just have to see how he does at Miami, man. I wish him the best success. I wish Miami the best success. And I like the pick, man. I like the pick. Miami fans, if you watching this video, man, let me know how you feel about it. Do you love it? How do you feel about the dude returning back home? You know, let me know what are y'all expectations for him. But most importantly, man, please like this video. Please subscribe to it, man. I got more content coming. And I appreciate the support, man. I've been getting a lot of support, man. We've been growing, and I really appreciate it, man. I love all of y'all, man. Thank y'all so much, man.